number six, we need to start by looking at the horizontal asymptote, so we can see that m up here is bigger than n down here. The degree up here is bigger than the degree down here, so we are going to have an oblique asymptote. So to find that, we have to just divide this out using long division. We have to use long division because the divisor there is quadratic. Put your 0x there for a placeholder. So we'll put x there. That gives me x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4x when I multiply each of these. And then I subtract. 2 minus 3 is negative 1. 0 minus negative is going to be plus 4x. And so I need to put a minus 1 up here. So negative 1 times x squared is negative 1x squared. Negative 3x, positive 4. At this point, it doesn't really matter what the remainder is, because we're going to ignore it anyway. So essentially, this is going to be my oblique asymptote at y equals x minus 1. And we ignore the remainder here because it's so insignificant in the context of the whole problem. It's so tiny that we can just ignore it. To look for holes, we of course need to factor everything. That denominator is going to factor outright x plus 4, x minus 1. The numerator, however, we're going to have to use p's and q's on. So I'm going to come over here. So my p is 9, so 1, 3, and 9. Q is 1, so p over q has a total of 6 values. Don't forget your 0 placeholder again. I think those are all positive. Yep. And so since all of these are positive, I know I should try a negative root to begin with. And I think I'm going to use, negative 3 works. Negative 3, negative 1, 3, 3, negative 9. Okay, so this is one of my factors, x plus 3. And then I just need to factor this quadratic that I get left. And you can try to factor it, but it won't work, because that would give me negative 2. So I'm going to have these two factors in the numerator up here, x plus 3, x squared minus x plus 3. Okay, so this is now the factored form, the simplified factored form. So we can see that nothing cancels, so we have no holes. The x-intercepts, of course, come from putting y equals 0, which means you can multiply by this whole denominator, which is still going to be 0 over here. So essentially, just these two things are where my x-intercepts are coming from. So I have one x-intercept at negative 3, and I could potentially have two irrational x-intercepts here, or these might be imaginary. We don't really know until we do the quadratic formula. So we'll come over here and do the quadratic formula. Positive 1 minus 12. Okay, so right here I can see this is going to end up being imaginary, which means I don't have any other x-intercepts, so I don't have to finish that problem. The y-intercept, of course, go back to the original problem. Plug in 0 for x's, so it's just going to be this right here, which is just 9 over negative 4. Vertical asymptotes are where the graph is undefined. Well, the graph is undefined when this is equal to 0, when either of these are equal to 0. So I'm going to have vertical asymptotes at negative 4 and at 1. And the last thing I need to check for is if it crosses. And this is probably the least exciting thing to check for. So we need to see if it's going to cross x minus 1. That's the asymptote that we're checking to see if it crosses. So we're going to set x minus 1 equal to this version, this simplified version, or this one, either one, since nothing canceled out, it doesn't matter. And so we want to see if they are crossing, so we're going to set them equal to each other and see if they intersect. So we'll set x minus 1 equal to, it'll be easier if we do this one. Okay, so we're going to multiply by the denominator. Cancel. We have to distribute here. So x cubed plus 3x squared minus 4x minus x squared minus 3x plus 4. And that's going to just be equal to this stuff. The x cubes cancel. If I combine these, I get 2x squared. And if I combine these, I get negative 7x. The 2x squareds cancel. So negative 7x equals 5. So it does cross when x is negative 5 over 7. So to find the y value for where it crosses, we can plug it into either one. We plug it into the original or to this one. This one's going to be a lot easier. So the y value is going to be negative 5 over 7 minus 1. So get a common denominator. And so negative 12 over 7. That is where it's crossing. And so all I need to do now is graph everything that I have. So we have the oblique asymptote we'll do first. We start at negative 1. And then we have a slope of 1 over 1. Just be careful, make sure you stay on the corners. And then we have vertical asymptotes at negative 4 and 1. And then we're going to have x-intercept at negative 3, y-intercept at negative 9 over 4, which is just past negative 2. And we're crossing at, so negative 5 sevenths is almost negative 1, and this is almost negative 2, so kind of almost negative 1, and almost going to cross right there on that horizontal asymptote. Those are the only points I have, so we know that this middle piece is going to hug the asymptotes like this. And then the other two sides, we have to look at the multiplicities of the vertical asymptotes here, and since they're both 1, we know that they're going to go on opposite sides. So if this one is approaching negative infinity on the left, it's going to approach positive infinity on the right, and it just follows the asymptotes. Same thing over here. If this is approaching positive infinity on the right, it's going to approach negative infinity on the left, and just hug the asymptotes that way.